Imagine being in a place with no sun. It's dark and gloomy. All you see from day to day is low-hanging sullen clouds. All you hear is the pattering of rain on the roof of your house. After several weeks with no sign of clear sky, you realize you're stuck in the wettest place on Earth. But this understanding will come later. Right now, you're a newcomer to the village of Mausanram in the Indian state of Meghalaya. The place sits on top of the Khasi Hills, boasts tons of stunning views. At least, that's what you've seen on the internet. So far, everything lives up to your expectations. All that lush greenery is amazingly refreshing after the heat of the plains. You would enjoy the place even more if it wasn't for persistent heavy rain. It makes the whole adventure a bit too wet to your liking. But well, whatever tap is open up there in the sky, it'll run out of water in a day or two, right? If only you knew how naive and over-optimistic you are while thinking so. You will learn the truth, but later, just wait. Right now, you're standing at the door of your rented hut. You've already discovered its curious feature. The whole construction has grass sticking out of the most unusual places. Even weirder, this grass seems to soundproof the little house from the deafening rain. You can't but wonder if downpours really get this bad in the area. Suddenly, you notice something you've never seen before. There's a group of men walking past your hut. There wouldn't be anything uncommon about that, but instead of covering their heads with good old umbrellas, they're carrying some curious constructions. Whatever those are, they're doing a great job, protecting the men from getting completely drenched. Later, you'll find out that what looks like small, lightweight boats turned upside down are actually local umbrellas, nups. Made of banana leaves and bamboo, they're super popular here. Nups are worn on the head rather than carried. It allows people to use both their hands while working and protects them from heavy rainstorms and severe winds. Anyway, you get tired of waiting for the rain to stop and head inside. You're tired after your trip. Hopefully, you'll wake up in the morning and sunshine will be the first thing you see. Several hours later, you find out it's probably time to tamp down your optimism. When you open your eyes, it's gloomy outside, and the rain keeps pattering on the roof. Whoa, where's everything? Thick fog hides the nearest trees, buildings, and even the road in front of your house. Or is it a cloud you're in? Whatever this is, it makes the surroundings look mysterious and eerie. The nightmarish white nothingness around is spine-chilling. It's also dark indoors, even though it's daytime. Quite soon, you start feeling bored. Ha! You wouldn't complain if you knew that villagers sometimes don't go outside for months at a time. You check again, and the cloud, or is it thick fog, seems to have passed. It's still raining heavily, but you decide you've had enough of staying inside. It's time to explore the place. Little do you know that on that adventure, you'll find the answers to all the questions that have been plaguing your mind. And the most important of them is, does this rain ever stop? Careful, you may not like what you learn. Probably a bad idea. You think, after your umbrella suddenly flies out of your hand and a stream of cold and, well, wet water runs down your back. But you can't give up now. Your feet are soaked, and no wonder, rainwater is surging through the streets. In some places, you have to conquer ankle-high puddles. Everything around looks as if it hasn't stopped raining for ages here. You have nothing to lose, so you leave the village and go sightseeing. The place is simply breathtaking. It has lots of waterfalls and weirdly shaped caves created in the limestone by the ever-falling water. And then, you see something that makes your jaw drop. It's a bridge, but isn't it made out of… Right. Those are tree roots. Someone knotted and tied them to create a passage over a deep gorge in the jungle. Come to think of it, it shouldn't be all that astonishing. If such severe rains aren't rare in this place, traditional building materials, like wood, must rot away really fast. By this point, you're feeling like a drowned rat. It's time to return to the village. After half walking, half wading through the rainwater for a half hour or so, you reach the first houses and spot a small diner. That's when you notice you're shivering. But it's India! Isn't it supposed to be hot here? You enter the almost empty cafe and take a seat. A middle-aged man, probably the owner, comes up to get your order. Maybe here you can find not only hot food, but also some answers. When the man returns with your meal, he seems eager to take a break and chat with you. He's surprised you know so little about their unique village. This place has even got to the Guinness World Records for having the highest annual rainfall. Every year, we have more than 467 inches of rain. The cafe owner sounds as if he's ready to burst with pride. You can't contain your surprise. That's so much rain that the Statue of Liberty would be up to her knees in water. The man keeps going. But it's rarely hot in Mossenrom. The average temperatures here vary from 52 degrees in the winter to 68 degrees in the summer. Oh, by the way, if you came in January or February, you'd see the dry season. Oh, great. Who knew you had to come to this place in the winter? But the man isn't finished. During this season, we don't have much rain, just a bit over 2 inches or so. So, still not totally dry. And finally, the owner is ready to unveil the mystery of why his native village receives more rain than any other place on the planet. There is not one, but three reasons for that. One of them is the monsoon. During this period, warm, moist winds from the Bay of Bengal are moving north. They meet over the Khasi Hills, which makes all the moisture they contain more concentrated. And since the Khasi Hills stretch east to west, they end up right in the way of the air coming from the ocean. During the monsoon, wild winds pull the humid ocean air over the hills and into the upper atmosphere. And it's another thing that makes the rainfall so continuous. There's admiration in the cafe owner's voice as he finishes his speech. It's a lot of rain here, it's true. I remember that time when the monsoon season lasted for 2 years, and there were no breaks in the rain whatsoever. When it happens, there's nothing left but to wait it out. But we're used to it. Sooner or later, you'll get used to it too.